everybody. Welcome to my homestead and welcome to my channel. So something huge has happened today. Well, I guess it happened a couple days ago, but this man right here, this is like a huge influential rabbi. He was buried today. Okay, his name is Chaim.
Hi everybody, welcome to my homestead and welcome to my channel. As you can see here, we have three new baby turkeys. I don't know exactly what breed they are. At the place that we got them from, Atwoods, which is like a farm store, there was just bronze and white, and they were out of the bronzes, which I wanted at least one of those, but we went ahead, we got three whites. I don't know if that they're broad-breasted whites. I don't know if they're a couple of the other breeds that there are, but I guess we'll find out once they're bigger. So we have them inside the house because not only did we get these three, but we're getting some chickens from McMurray Hatchery, and this is not a paid promotion, by the way, but we're doing like a essentially like a great reset of our flock. What happens is when you have a flock of chickens, we have our electric fence, and in the beginning, there's usually just like one, maybe two chickens that the electric fence doesn't bother, and they just like keep getting out, you know, and it's no big deal. But then over time, you'll get that bad influence will spread, and it spreads like a disease, and then everybody just starts going out of the electric fence, which we can't have because we're here in town. I mean, we're on like the kind of like the outskirts of town, but we're still in town, and I can't have chickens going into the neighboring properties. So the idea is to just order a brand new set of chickens. We sold the old ones. We're going to get them. We're going to process a bunch of them and then just keep maybe somewhere around like, I don't know, 6, 7, 8, just like a smaller flock, because I think that they're going to not break up into different groups as much if they're smaller. So we're just trying it out, and we're going to see if that works. So so yeah, we have them inside instead of outside like we normally would, because we have kind of like a brooder outside. But because of some of the money that we're spending on these guys, we want to absolutely make sure that as many of them will survive as possible. It's almost guaranteed anytime that you have a batch of chicks that there's going to be one that dies. That's what I've noticed, not only in our own experience, but talking to other people. There's always just like weak chicks. But anyway, we're going to see if we can just try and get them all to survive. We've done it before. It's happened a couple times, but anyway. So in this video, I wanted to talk just a little bit about the 144,000 and the 10 lost tribes, because, well, we were recently talking about this in a recent video, and I have a thought experiment. Okay, I'm sure I'm not the only one that's ever brought this up, but I've never seen anybody really respond to it. I don't know. Well, let me just put it to you like this. Okay, so let's pretend that there really is a main body of 10 lost tribes. They're somewhere in the earth, under the ice caps, in space, on the moon, whatever. Okay, and then let's say that they come, and according to this theory, they're supposed to come to our church, the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, and be crowned by Ephraim, and at that point, then the 144,000 can be selected, right? 12,000 from every tribe, and then there's supposed to be like a special mission that takes place where they go throughout the world and, you know, do missionary work, right? So my question is, and this is honest, this is sincere, for anybody that is of this frame of mind or this is your belief, when they come to the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, what is the rest of the world going to do? I mean, first of all, are they just going to be permitted to come within the borders of the United States? Is the world going to find it a little bit odd that they're coming just to our church? Is that going to cause like a mass conversion? Because, see, that's one of the problems that I have with this is I don't think that that's part of the plan, you know? The Lord doesn't tend to do things in a way that gives people proof and then they convert. So, for example, the gold plates. We don't have the gold plates anymore. They were taken up. And it's my understanding that part of that reason is because it's to try the faith of people, right? You shouldn't be coming to the church because you have objective proof, right? Now, the Lord does do personal miracles. He speaks to you. The Spirit speaks to you and can give you signs, can give you revelation. But like on a mass scale, the Lord doesn't tend to leave like physical hard evidence that, you know, to where, because like if we still did have the gold plates right now, and if the world was able to examine them and be like, oh yeah, no, this is real. Think about how many people would be part of the church right now, but not for the right reasons. Not for the right reasons. The Lord is looking for Israel. He's looking for those that, according to President Nelson in his last two regional firesides or devotionals, he said that those in the pre-existence, the greatest gift that you could have was the gift of spirituality. And so those are basically the ones that we're looking for in this life is Israel, right? Not those that do things because they have proof. That's not the Lord's way. There's a trial of faith. And so that's just like one problem that I have with that theory is if the whole world witnessed, if they all witnessed, you know, this unknown, up until now, unknown civilization suddenly come out of nowhere or a place that we didn't know could be inhabited, and then they go to our church, I feel like that would be akin to the gold plates suddenly coming and then everybody being able to be like, oh, yep, this is it, right? So that's one question that I have for everybody is how do you picture it happening? If you, now I don't accept it at all. I don't believe that there's a main body that's hidden somewhere. I used to, simply because I didn't know any better. It's just like one of those things that's like handed down to you. You know, you're talking to your uncles and they're like, yeah, you know, there's 12 tribes and there was Admiral Byrd and he went to the North Pole and he came in contact with them and, you know, they had way better technology and da 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 da. You know, since that time, I've given that up. I don't believe it. And, you know, I've already covered it ad nauseum on the channel. But all I'm trying to get at is I know that there's those of you that watch the channel. You do believe that there's a main group of 12 tribes or sorry, 10 lost tribes somewhere in that when they get back, then there's going to be this calling of 144,000, which I don't believe that either. Like not in that sense. And I covered that in the last video. And Teresa Washington, she actually left a really good comment, which I can't remember. She was basically quoting somebody. There's like something that I can go look up, a commentary that somebody gave on the 144,000. So I'm gonna check that out, probably do a video on it. But you know, for those of you that believe that, and that's fine, you know, I don't think that you're dumb or stupid or doing something wrong by believing that. I just, I don't personally think that it's right. But if you're of that frame of mind, how do you see that playing out? How does the rest of the world react? Is there like a sudden wave of conversions because of this? Because they see these unknown Israelites coming to the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. I think I've actually heard some people talk about how, well, what's going to happen is like the entire world is going to be at war. And so they're going to come to the Saints. The Saints are going to be in Missouri. And they're essentially going to have like a city, a base, an area that the Ten Lost Tribes will protect with their technology and power and stuff like that. So no one will dare fight against Zion. So at that point, you know, the United States will be at civil war and the Ten Lost Tribes will have claimed, you know, this land for the Saints, the Kansas City area, I guess. I don't know. Like, spell it out for me. I want to see. I just want to know how you see it logically playing out. Okay. I know that there's another school of thought that believe that they have been translated, just like the city of Enoch and Melchizedek, which, okay, that's, I feel like that's more plausible, that maybe they would come down at the same time that Enoch does. I still don't think that that's right, but that could be. Excuse me. I guess that's all I have for this one. Just a short video. At the time that I'm recording this, it's Monday night, and it's been a hectic day, so I wasn't really able to do much by way of doing YouTube videos. But that'll be it for this one. So if you haven't already, please make sure to subscribe, like this video if you liked it. Leave your thoughts, leave your information, leave your comments. Also make sure to share this, and I'll talk to you guys later.